Hey everyone, it's me, Olivia, and today I'm just gonna be talking about life. So as a lot of you know, I am stopping my Squishmallow collecting, which means this channel is no longer really Squishmallow related, like, at all. And so I just wanna talk about why I'm stopping collecting, what that means for this channel, and just give a few little other life updates. So the reason why I'm quitting my Squishmallow collecting is, I guess the main reason is because it's just a waste of money. I love Squishmallows, like, with my whole entire heart, and I'm definitely gonna keep a good amount of my collection, but I have sold a lot of my collection already. But honestly, it is kind of pointless because, one, I know that Squishmallows are higher in value technically than like what they're being sold in store for now, but whenever I sell them, I just feel guilty about it, and so to me they're not really like worth a lot. Like, some people, they like collecting because they think that Squishmallows are worth something. But to me, I disagree with the high overpricedness of it. So like, to me, I'm just like, oh, I literally just have stuffed animals that are worth nothing. Does that make any sense? I don't know if that does, but just there's really no value in them to me. So that's one reason why I think I need to stop, because what am I doing this for? Do they even bring me that much joy? Not really. Buying them, like, yes, so exciting. It was fun to go out and shop for them. Like, that was like the highlight of my day. It was the only thing to get me out of the house for the longest time, and I definitely do miss having that to get me out of the house, because now I'm back in the house quite a lot. But in the end, I think that like not worrying about and stressing about literally stuffed animals is gonna benefit me. I'm almost 20. I don't need to be literally just hoarding stuffed animals. I'm not trying to shame on anyone that's my age or a little bit younger or older that is Squishmallow collecting, because trust me, I get it. I get the hype and I would love to continue, but when I've really taken a look at it, Squishmallows are kind of heavily correlated with the decline in my mental health, and that's huge for me. I really started getting into them in September, like around my birthday, and I didn't think anything of it. I'm like, oh, it's just like something I'm excited for, like they're cute, whatever, not gonna worry about it. But that's around the time that my mental health really was just going down and I just couldn't even function anymore. I really do blame a big portion of it on Squishmallows, because Squishmallows were the only thing I was putting my energy into. I was putting way too much energy into them. I was stressing about them to make sure I can get them whenever I can. And it just was like a lot on my plate over stuffed animals. So I did not need that. I was also stressed because I didn't have a job, because that is also around the time that I lost my job again because they shut down. So I was buying stuff that I really did not have the means or money for to afford. So that brought me to around like a month or two ago when I realized, okay, this needs to stop. And stopping is really hard. I have to admit, I literally just like bought some a week ago and they came in the mail the other day and it brought me joy. But I've been slowly just like stopping checking. I left every single Facebook group. I just instantly scroll past any TikTok relating to Squishmallows. I'm just trying to detach myself from them. And if you're still at this point in the video, if you guys could just not talk about Squishmallows to me anymore, I would appreciate that, because talking about them is just gonna make me go back and I really don't wanna go back. So if you guys could help me not go back, that would be amazing. So what does this mean for my channel? Because I pretty much, in the past like 7 months, centered my channel around Squishmallows, which was never really the plan, not gonna lie. Like, I did not intend for this to be a Squishmallow channel, but I like posted a video, my collection video, and it blew up and I was like, okay, this is fun. Plus I'm enjoying collecting them, so might as well just film myself as I'm collecting them. And I enjoyed it a lot, but now I'm over that and I don't really know where to go with my channel, because most of my audience wants that and I'm not gonna give that anymore. And I don't wanna lose you guys, because I love you guys so much and all your support. So one, if you guys can help me, like, what do you want me to do? Preferably if you can give me ideas that don't really cost money, that would be great. But I think I'm gonna like try and just like make my channel kind of like a mix between daily vlogs, if my life ever gets interesting, hopefully. I don't know, vlogs may not work out because I have a pretty boring life, and it's just gonna be like sit down videos, maybe like testing certain product stuff. Like, I've posted a few of those this past month and those are fun, but again, it's money, so I can only do those every so often. I don't know, I'm like not really a creative person, but at the same time I am. I'm just really bad at like coming up with ideas, but once I have one, I get a good vision on how I want to execute and everything. But if you want to throw any ideas out there for me, please, that would be so helpful. And now I'm just gonna give a little bit of an update on where my life is right now, because things are a little bit weird right now, and that may result in me posting less. I've been trying to post at least twice a week, but I don't know if I have the time to really like dedicate fully to YouTube to do twice a week. I'll definitely try to do once a week, but I don't know. It's just kind of going to be a toss up. I don't really know. But right now I'm trying to post Mondays and Fridays at 3 o'clock, and we'll hope that works, but I don't know. I'll keep you updated on my little scheduling, but let's talk about why I've had to reduce the amount of videos. First thing is, one, I don't have my niche anymore. I don't know what I'm really supposed to be posting, so it is a lot more effort and energy to make a video because I can't just film myself squishmallow hunting. So it is just harder in general to come up with video ideas. Two, I've been trying to really focus on my real estate studies because I have failed my exam twice now, and that's not fun. I'm not excited to have to take it a third time, and who knows, that might not even be the last time. So I need to really dedicate my life to that. And I actually got a job again at my old work, the movie theater. So I'm gonna be working like only 2 days a week there, but I might add in a third day. So I also will have that on my plate. And the shifts there are kind of intense and long, and they go late and they're exhausting. So that's another reason why I won't be able to post as much as I was, because I have work. But that's also good because I'll be making money again. And just in general, I've been trying to like just focus on building more relationships with people, new friends, old friends, whatever, and just like getting myself, my life back together, because like I said, my mental health was so bad between like September and kind of still now, but it is getting better because I've been actually trying to take the time to focus on myself and not really like focus on other things such as like YouTube. I have definitely taken such a step back the last 2 months, and that has helped. And I've been just trying to be selfish, I guess, which I've always kind of been like a selfish person, not gonna lie, but I'm really being selfish. But I think it's honestly like benefiting everyone, because when I was in my mental health decline, like I wouldn't see anyone. If I did see anyone, it was for like an hour at a time because I couldn't handle it. I couldn't go to restaurants or anything, but I've been working on that, and I ate at a restaurant for the first time today, and I was mainly fine, like went through some mini anxieties, but we're getting there. We're getting better. We're trying to get back to normal because the unnamed pandemic just destroyed all of us in some way, and it made me a person that I don't even recognize, and I'm starting to recognize myself again, so that's nice. Plus I am newly-ish single, so you know, trying to put myself out there. A little bit nervous, you know, I'm like ready but not ready for a relationship, but I kind of like being in relationships, or at least just like dating, you know, something. So I also kind of had that on my mind, trying to pursue them boys. And I get very stressed over boys. I hate it, but you know, it's how it is. So I guess like I'm just in a weird phase of my life. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do, how I want to do it, what I want to be, who I want to be. That's all the same thing pretty much. In the end, I'm going to conclude this and just say things are changing. I hope you stick with me through these changes, and hopefully that you can like support me, help me, encourage me, all of that. I appreciate you all so much. And if you want to stick around, if you are new, press the subscribe button. Or if you're not new and you're not subscribed, do it. And the bell notification icons, because then you can be notified whenever I post. Plus, that'll be a benefit because I don't really know exactly what I'm going to be posting anymore. So put on those notifications. You will know when I have posted. And with that said, I love you guys so much. Thanks for sticking around with me as I just brain dump about my life. And I'll see you in the next one.